إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، إمام المرسلين وخاتم النبيين وصفوة من الخلق أجمعين، سيدي سادات العرب والعجم، فخر ربيع ومضر، فيا أيها الراجون شفاعته أكثر من الصلاة عليه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. اهتدت عين بنظر، وضعت أذن بخبر، وقطرت السماء بمطر، وتنفس كل حاقد وانقهر. ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. أما بعد، praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one we ask help, mercy, forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the bad deeds of ourselves and the evil of our souls. Whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided will never be misguided. But whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguide, leave them to be astray, abandon them, leave them to be in charge of their own self and soul, they will never be guided. They are in a serious trouble. I bear witness there is no Lord or deity worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Jalla fi ula, and Muhammad, peace be upon him, his servant, his messenger, the best and purest of Allah's creation, the face of glad tidings, the most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As to follow, respected brothers and sisters, dear believers, respected elders, the best greetings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all of you, and upon all the bright faces that came to prostrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one and only one deserving of your beautiful face to put in the ground in prostration to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to all the sincere hearts that finds comfort, happiness, satisfaction, content, success with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With there's no success except with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Genuine success, organic success in this dunya, in the grave, qabristan, in the hereafter, only with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Respected, wonderful brothers and sisters, today's khutbah to do with some of the events with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the ethics of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If I have lisan min al-jannah, if I have a tongue from heaven, I could never pinpoint the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I had to gargle and clean my mouth with zamzam outside in the parking of this Amrullah masjid just to speak about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pinpointed a reality that when you follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, اتبعوا ولا تبتدعوا. Follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do not innovate. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guaranteed two major blessings for you. When you follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will be sin free and you'll be loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sin free? Yes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. Say, O Muhammad, if you loved Allah, then follow me, Allah would love you. Allah would love you and forgive your sins. So this is a major benefit. May Allah help me and you, respected, wonderful brothers and sisters, to follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and copy Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with sincerity. With sincerity, this way you are guaranteed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are guaranteed by Allah Jannah fi ula, forgiveness and love by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't need more than this in this dunya, in the grave, in the hereafter. You need these two major matters. حب الله سبحانه وتعالى والمغفرة. Forgiveness of Allah سبحانه وتعالى and the love of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. So therefore, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم's teaching, talking, walking, all it has to do with one sentence, one only. الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر. Enjoining in what's good, forbidding what's bad. You, Muslims of Canada, Muslims of the world, you are labeled. You're labeled with the worst names. Terrorists. You're labeled with the most aggressive names. Why? because you are enjoying in what's good and forbidding what's bad. And the superpower in this world, there is a superpower in this world, wants to spoil and to spread fasad, evil, and they bank by that. They benefit by that big time, and you Muslims ruining that for them. Ruining it for them. You want goodness in land and to forbid what's evil. This is what Islam, al-amr bil-ma'ruf wa nahi anil munkar. And that's what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a nutshell, al-amr bil-ma'ruf wa nahi anil munkar. Enjoying what's good, forbidding what's bad. And that's why the superpower of this world, the criminals of this world, the gangs of this world, al-usabat wal-mujrimeen, wal-mutahakimeen fi al-alam, they label you with the worst names to scare people away from Islam. And in reality, Islam is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants us to do. And Allah above all, subhana, jalla fi ula, wants us to enjoy in what's good and forbid what's bad. How Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam speaking of the best of Allah's creation, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was always mubashiran. He was always giving a glad tiding. Learn this habit from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To be a face of bushra, a face of glad tiding. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if he got the choice between two matters, he always chose the easiest one. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants you to take it easy in certain things and not to be hard on yourself. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of Allah's creation, if you get the addiction, the idman in your life, be addicted with saying sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will be guaranteed by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who speak the ultimate truth, إِذَنْ تُكْفَى هَمَّكْ وَيُغْفَرْ ذَنْبَكْ. Means you will be sin free and you will be relieved from your worries. يُكْفَى هَمَّكْ وَيُغْفَرْ ذَنْبَكْ. So be addicted with salawat upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You will never prove me wrong. Never, ever. You will have an ultimate good life. You will be having an amazing life if you're always being addicted with salawat upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters, honorable believers, the time does not allow me to speak much about the best of Allah's creation, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But I want to take you to an incident where I want you to prepare your heart. Prepare your heart, brother. Get your heart ready. Fix your heart for this amazing good news. Truly, this news, keep it in your heart for the rest of your life. I will tell you something, perhaps you read it many times, but this is an incident happened, and you gotta take this as the gift, hadiyat umrak, the gift of your life. What happened? Sa'd bin Abi Waqqas, radiallahu anhu, going into the Masjid al-Nabawi, the Masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the Medina al-Munawwara, and then he saw Uthman bin Affan, radiallahu anhu. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh. Uthman bin Affan did not reply. He did not reply. He looked at him, he stared at him, but he did not reply. So Sa'd bin Abi Waqqas, he was shocked. What happened? Right away, went to Umar bin al-Khattab, Amir al-Mu'mineen, radiallahu anhu. Al-Imlaq, the giant, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Umar bin al-Khattab, radiallahu anhu. Sa'd bin Abi Waqqas complained. He said, Amir al-Mu'mineen, leader of the believers, is there anything happened with Islam? Is there anything changed with Islam? He said, no. Why? He said, I said, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. I greeted Uthman bin Affan. He looked at me. He stared at me, but he did not reply. He did not answer me back. Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah. Right away, Umar bin Khattab radiallahu anhu called the giant, Al-Imlaq Al-Thani, Uthman bin Affan, radiallahu anhum, he called him, did you do that? He said, salamu alaykum to you, and he did not reply. Did that happen? He said, no, it did not happen. He said, Sa'id said, no, it did happen. Uthman ibn Affan said, wallahi, it did not happen. Both, they made a qasam, both of them. And then right away, Uthman ibn Affan said, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Yes, yes, it did happen. He said, why? Because I was thinking deep. I was so much in deep thinking with something happened with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam just about to tell us a dua, a very powerful dua, and then he got interrupted by A'rabi, by a man. And then we didn't know the dua, I didn't know the dua. And every time I think about this, ghashawa, just like a shade, a cover, a blanket, covers my face and covers my heart. I don't see things in front of me. Every time I think about what did Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam wants to teach us, a very powerful dua. Sa'id bin Abi Waqqas said, I know the dua. I was there and I followed Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he finished from Al-Arabi, when he finished from the man. I followed him to his house and I knocked with my foot in the ground. Respect to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Knocked in the foot. Rasulullah sallallahu looked behind him. He saw Sa'd bin Abi Waqqas radiyallahu anhu. He said, Abu Ishaq, what's up? He said, oh Prophet of Allah, no, just I want to ask you about that you're going to tell us something. And then the Arabi interrupted. He said, this is the dua of Yunus when he was swallowed by the whale. He said, every Muslim will make this dua, Allah will answer their prayers. Allah will answer their supplication. When you use this dua, La ilaha illa ant, subhanak inni kuntu min al-zalimin. No Lord worthy of worship except you. Subhanak, glory to you, I was among the wrongdoers. He said, this is the dua. Every Muslim will say this dua, your supplication will be answered. This is the dua of Prophet Yunus alayhi salam, my dear brothers and sisters. He was swallowed by the whale. Three darkness. The darkness of the stomach of the whale, the darkness of the sea, the water, the darkness of the night. Three darkness upon darkness. 911 would not work. Nobody would rescue Yunus alayhi salam except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a very powerful dua, tested and trusted. This is a very powerful dua, learn it from a young age. We have youth among us. Learn it and keep it for the rest of your life. Whatever you want to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make this dua, then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In between, after, whatever. La ilaha illa ant, subhanak, inni kuntu min al-zalimin. This is in the Holy Quran, this dua. It's Al-Anbiya verse, Al-Anbiya verse number 87. Al-Anbiya raqam 87. So keep this engraved in your heart. This is the gift of your life. This is my beard, this is my beard. Use my beard as a vacuum cleaner, right? Because you cannot prove me wrong. If you prove me wrong, use it as a vacuum cleaner. You'll never prove me wrong. Never! Why? It's from Allah. Our Rasulullah ﷺ tested and trusted. Take this, be happy. When you leave the masjid today, do a good donation for the masjid. Why? Because you have a gift from Allah and Rasulullah ﷺ. You will never, look at me in the eye, you will never face me. Respected, wonderful brothers and sisters, you will never face me and tell me it did not work. It worked 100%. We don't accept 99%. Tested and trusted. This is the gift of your life. What can we benefit from this incident? ما هي الفوائد من هذه الحادثة? What the benefit from this great story, real story, genuine, organic story? What's the benefit? I will tell you the benefit after the break, inshallah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم فاستغفروا إنه نور السماوات والأرض غفور رحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين. رب اشرح صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم صل وسلم بارك على سيدنا محمد وجزا الله محمد عنا بما هو اهل. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward our Prophet Muhammad to the best of what he deserves on our behalf, on behalf of the past and future Muslim generations. Allahumma ameen. Respected, wonderful brothers and sisters, some of the benefit from this story, from this incident. Number one, Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu did not just take the complaint. No, he called Uthman ibn Affan. So learn in your life to verify. فَتَبَيَّنُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that in the Quran. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَأٍ فَتَبَيَّنُوا. Oh, you believe. If a fasiq, rebellious, comes to you with the news, verify. So number one, learn to verify. Learn to search for the truth. Learn to polish the truth. Number two, that don't think evil of your brothers and sisters, of your friends, of your workers, co-workers. Don't think evil of your, لا تسيء الظن, of your friends, أصدقائك, أقربائك. Don't think good of them. Maybe I say salam alaikum to you. You did not reply maybe because of the window, my car reflecting the light, you don't see me. Maybe for other reason, I'm looking at you but I'm not paying attention. Look at al-Shafi'i. Al-Shafi'i radiallahu anhu was ill, كان مريض. He was visited by a friend and the friend told him, قوى الله ضعفك. May Allah make your weakness strong. He said, wrong. He said, if Allah does that, Allah will kill me. He said, no, 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 I did not mean that. I did not mean that. He said, I know you did not mean that. Wallah, I think good of you and أحسن الظن فيك. Wallah, I think good of you that if you cursed me, clearly, if you cursed me, I will still think good of you. So therefore, this is benefit number two. Benefit number three, my dear brothers and sisters, لا تتركوا المشاكل والخلافات تعفن وتصدي. Don't leave problems and misunderstanding to rot and to become rusty. No, verify, talk, try to solve and dissolve the bad feeling. Number three, من عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه. Who's عثمان بن عفان؟ الله أكبر. رضي الله عنه. When he was wrong, right away, he apologized. Sorry. Astaghfirullah. So we need to learn to apologize for each other, for our children, for our relative, for whoever. We need to learn to apologize. And first and most, to apologize for Allah subhanahu. جل في علا الذي لا تنفعه طاعة الطاعين ولا تضره معصية الكافرين ولا يضره شيء. الله سبحانه وتعالى to apologize for Allah, the one who does not benefit by the believers. Nothing could benefit Allah سبحانه وتعالى and nothing could harm Allah سبحانه وتعالى. So therefore, dear brothers and sisters, this is a gift, this is a major gift. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم memorize this, use it daily. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. So therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, before I continue the khutbah, I would like also to remind the brothers and the sisters that as of December 3rd, in this honorable masjid, you'll be required to show your vaccine COVID-19 passport from age 12 and up, from December 3rd of this year, 2021. So be aware of that. Jazakum Allah khair. May Allah keep loving you, protecting you. I will leave you with one more ethics of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Today, I have the honor to speak about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and I have the honor to speak in front of honorable people like you. So to end this reminder, رب مستمع خير ممتكلم might be a listener much better than a speaker. To end this khutbah, I will end it with the following. Look what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do when he used to see Fatima al-Zahra radiallahu anha. كان يقف يبتسم يمشي إليها يقبلها في forehead جبين ثم يجلسها مجلسه. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he used to see Fatima Zahra, do you do this with your children? Do you do this with your wife? Let us try this. You'll be amazed. When he used to see Fatima Zahra radiallahu anha, he used to get up from his seat, smile, walk to her, walk to Fatima Zahra, kiss her in the forehead, and number five, give her the seat. Give her his seat. Look, one, two, three, four, five. It makes a fist of goodness, a fist of kindness, a fist of the behaviors of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do we do that? Get up, smile, greet, walk, kiss in the forehead, and give the seat. Try it, you'll be a happy camper. Respected brothers and sisters, dear believers, I would end my khutbah with what I started with, that if I have a tongue from heaven, I could never pinpoint the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. By following Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for those who just arrived to the khutbah, by following Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will gain the love of Allah and the forgiveness of Allah. اتبعوا ولا تبتدعوا. Follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do not make bid'ah, innovation. قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. It's in the Holy Quran that if you say, O Muhammad, if you love Allah, then follow me, Allah would love you and forgive your sins. Allahu Akbar. What? If I follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if I practice the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if I put in practice the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah would love me and forgive my sins. Yes, it's in the Holy Quran. The ultimate truth, there's no button if there's no class. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayta, wa'afina fi man afayta, Allahumma shafi mardana, ihdi dhurriyatan, ahyina hayatan tayyiba. اللهم انصر اخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم اجمعنا واحبابهم شهداء الفردوس الاعلم غير سالف عداد. يا الله, you love forgiveness. اللهم grant us your forgiveness. اللهم guide our children. اللهم heal our loved ones. اللهم heal our ill ones. اللهم grant us the good life you promised in the Holy Quran. يا رب العالمين, يا الله, يا رب العالمين, make our brothers and sisters victorious wherever they are oppressed. Allahumma unite us with their shuhada, martyrs in paradise, without any previous punishment, without any previous accountable wrong. He said, if Allah does that, Allah will kill me. He said, no, I did not mean that. I did not mean that. He said, I know you did not mean that. Wallah, I think good of you and ahsan al-dhan feek. Wallah, I think good of you that if you cursed me, clearly, if you cursed me, I will still think good of you. So therefore, this is benefit number two. Benefit number three, my dear brothers and sisters, لا تتركوا المشاكل والخلافات تعفن وتصدي. Don't leave problems and misunderstanding to rot and to become rusty. No, verify, talk, try to solve and dissolve the bad feeling. Number three, من عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه. Who's عثمان بن عفان؟ الله أكبر. رضي الله عنه. When he was wrong, right away, he apologized. Sorry. أستغفر الله. So we need to learn to apologize for each other, for our children, for our relative, for whoever. We need to learn to apologize. And first and most, to apologize for Allah subhanahu. جل في علا الذي لا تنفعه طاعة الطاعين ولا تضره معصية الكافرين ولا يضره شيء. الله سبحانه وتعالى, to apologize for Allah, the one who does not benefit by the believers. Nothing could benefit Allah سبحانه وتعالى, and nothing could harm Allah سبحانه وتعالى. So therefore, dear brothers and sisters, this is a gift, this is a major gift. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم memorized this, use it daily. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. So therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, before I continue the khutbah, I would like also to remind the brothers and the sisters that as of December 3rd in this honorable masjid, you'll be required to show your vaccine COVID-19 passport from age 12 and up from December 3rd of this year, 2021. So be aware of that. Jazakumullah khair. May Allah keep loving you, protecting you. I will leave you with one more ethics of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Today, I have the honor to speak about Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And I have the honor to speak in front of honorable people like you. So to end this reminder, رُبَّ مُسْتَمِعٌ خَيْرٌ مُمَتَكَلِّمٌ might be a listener much better than a speaker. To end this khutbah, I will end it with the following. Look what Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to do when he used to see Fatima al-Zahra رضي الله عنها. كان يقف يبتسم يمشي إليها يقبلها في forehead جبين ثم يجلسها مجلسه. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he used to see Fatima Zahra, do you do this with your children? Do you do this with your wife? Let us try this. You'll be amazed. When he used to see Fatima Zahra radiallahu anha, he used to get up from his seat, smile, walk to her, walk to Fatima Zahra, kiss her in the forehead, and number five, give her the seat. Give her his seat. Look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it makes a fist of goodness, a fist of kindness, a fist of the behaviors of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do we do that? Get up, smile, greet, walk, kiss in the forehead, and give the seat. Try it, you'll be a happy camper. Respected brothers and sisters, dear believers, I would end my khutbah with what I started with, that if I have a tongue from heaven, I could never pinpoint the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. By following Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, for those who just arrived to the khutbah, by following Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you will gain the love of Allah and the forgiveness of Allah. اتبعوا ولا تبتدعوا. Follow Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Do not make bid'ah, innovation. قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم. It's in the Holy Quran that if you say, O Muhammad, if you love Allah, then follow me, Allah would love you and forgive your sins. Allahu Akbar. What? If I follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if I practice the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if I put in practice the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah would love me and forgive my sins. Yes, it's in the Holy Quran. The ultimate truth. There's no but and if. There's no class. Allahumma hadina fi man hadayt, wa'afina fi man afayt. Allahumma shafi mardana, ihdi dhurriyatan hina hayatan tayyiba. Allahumma ansur ikhwana al-mustadhafina fi kulli makan. Allahumma ijma'na wa ahbabahum shuhada al-firdaws al-a'la min ghayr sabiq adad. Ya Allah, your love forgiveness. Allahumma grant us your forgiveness. Allahumma guide our children. Allahumma heal our loved ones. Allahumma heal our ill ones. Allahumma grant us the good life you promised in the Holy Quran. Ya Rabb al-Alameen, Ya Allah, Ya Rabb al-Alameen, make our brothers and sisters victorious wherever they are oppressed. Allahumma unite us with their shuhada, martyrs in paradise. Without any previous punishment, without any previous accountability. Ameen. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Salaam Sayyidina Muhammad. Wa alayhi sahbihi ajma'in. Wa salaam alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.